Hey! Hello?
What's up? Let me get some tunes playing, and let me also get a little tweet out. Hey, what's up, guys? How is it freaking hanging? Hey! Matt, are you going to do a voice in season 2 of Smiling Friends? I would love to. If the people demand it, who knows? I'm just putting out a tweet that we live. Hey, what's up, guys? Thank you, Bean. All right. Hey, guys. What is up? Sorry, it's been 10 days. And I know you guys are like, oh shit, he stopped streaming again. But no, I'm, oh shit, I do need to eat food. What the fuck? Okay, what happened to my house? I just got on and my house, like, looks like a creeper blew up or some shit. I don't know. It looks like it got ransacked. Let me eat some food real quick. Cause I am dying. I'm gonna explain where I was. Hell yeah. Does that do the trick? Nice. Oh wow. Thank you, Diet Mayos, for gifting those subs. That's so, you guys are so sweet. Give me a Fricketness has subbed. Thank you, E-Dog 1023, the Shiny Boys. Thank you. And Very Lonely Tree. And Fricketness donated gifted 5 subs. And Rose Bitch just subbed. Thank you, guys. Yeah, so basically, what the fuck is that? What the hell was that sound? Fuck was that? Who's coming towards me? Okay, I wanna talk to chat. But who is that? Who is that? Yeah, it's been a minute since I've been on. Oh, does it still say Minecraft? Or does it say just chatting? I changed it. Hold on. Let me go change it on my Twitch.
You sound gay? No, you sound, you sound.
When, like, do I sound? Started auto playing another stream of mine.
You sound gay? No, you sound.
Wow, three going at once. Hold on a sec.
Hey.
One sec. My balls are not out. We're not starting this again. How do I change the game? There we go. Now my cock and balls are not showing. Okay, we're not doing this. We're not starting this way. But basically, yeah. Oh shit, Casey's back. I changed it so it says Minecraft now. My wet nips, my minge, none of that's out, okay? That's enough. Thank you for the bits. It's very, very sweet. But basically, Fish Kid, thank you for the sub. And Pingling, thank you for the sub. Yeah, so it's been a little bit of a week or so. I had a couple guests staying with me. I had Trevor, and I also had Lex staying with me. So I had people with me for about a week, and when I had people with me, Trevor was staying in this room. I just didn't really feel up to streaming, because I was just busy hanging with friends IRL, you know? I don't know if you guys would get that, but... yeah, but then also, I've just been dealing with some personal stuff on the side that's been insanely rough. And on top of that, this last week I had some medical stuff that was pretty not fun. So I am finally feeling better. And you know, things are looking up. And I'm ready to jump back onto this epic S&P. So let's see. I'm coming back. Let's see where we left off, okay? Let's see what we're doing. My house is fucked. Somebody fucked my house up a little bit. I saw that Nathan Barnett and Marisa came in and put a bunch of funny signs everywhere, but those signs are now gone. I took those down in my free time. I will not give them the satisfaction. And I don't have any items because I put them all in a chest somewhere and died. Let's see. Oh wow, the jar is completely full. That's disgusting. Wow, look at that. Thanks for all these little bits. Oakreon, thanks for the sub. And Johnny Fantastico. That's a cool name. All right, but let's check out my skin. It's epic, right? Anyway, who's online right now? We got me, Ophelia, Layton, and Kronos. Okay, so I kind of have to go start fresh because I don't have anything now. What is that up there? Yeah, so there's lots of new stuff. What should I do today? That's the question. What do I do in Minecraft besides take off my hoodie because holy shit, it is hot in my streaming room. Almost showed nipple on stream. Whoops. Okie dokie. I got my Sum 41 shirt on. Hey, hype train. Would you guys still watch me if I laugh like that? If that was my legitimate laugh? Tin ads. No, what? Okay, so I guess I should probably, well, fuck this house, because every time I try to build a house in this game on this server, everyone fucks it up, so I might as well not even try to build a house. I kind of want to go off somewhere super far away and just start something new, you know, because Ryan and I have been talking about wanting just to go somewhere and just start fresh. So maybe I'll find a little spot for us, you know. Let's get the necessities. What is that? A smoker? Okay. Ladders. Iron pickaxe. Cool. That's good. I don't know what the fuck happened in here. Look at this. God damn. Yeah, so we shot a video today that was unbelievable. It was absolutely insane. It's the craziest thing we've ever shot by far. Ryan and Tucker got very ill halfway through shooting. But it was absolutely worth it. It was so fucking cool. I'm so proud of the boys. We were the first YouTubers in space. Unbelievable, guys. Couldn't have done it without you. But for real, we shot a fucking crazy video. I'm a little nauseous still from it. No, we did not go skydiving. It was not that Johnny Fantastico. Hey, Gregory Stream, thanks for the sub. Yeah, it was not that though. Way cooler than when I said we went to space, I mean we really went to space. I'm just gonna sail off this way and just keep going straight until I hit land, and then maybe start anew there. Oh, Don's here. Anti-gravity tube. It's not an anti-gravity tube. Yeah, and I missed all the griefing on my house. No, we weren't doing acid. We literally went to space. I'll just say that today I experienced, thank you HP Lovecrap. Today I experienced an experience that I will never experience again, and I think very, very few people in their lives will ever get to experience. That's right, I got hit from a family member, nonetheless, and I'll tell you what. Alright, it was not bad, you know. There's a big stigma around that for some reason, but I'm from South Carolina. I really, you know, don't see what the big problem is. But this is, hey! Oh, shit! Thank you, Tonk Lord, for gifting those dang subs. Oh, shit. So, yeah, so I guess if just going in a straight line is really just gonna get me, to a brand new continent where I can start fresh. All by myself. Oh, I hear dolphins. I just can't believe that, I'm glad it's not dead yet, the server. I was worried that while I was gone it would fully die. Not because I'm gone, but just because time goes by and, you know, etc., etc. Also, I got a new streaming background. I hope you guys enjoy it. Ooh. Wait, has someone been here before? What the hell? What is this? Has somebody been here? Oh, no. It's just... maybe. Okay, well, this is not the land to... maybe I can do it on top of that rock. Here. Let's see. Oh, is Ross on? Oh, shit. No, wait, sorry. Yeah, this is that rock looks like a pretty safe bet. I'm gonna try Rock Island over here. For my new home. There's no cum stains on my shirt. Stop it. I would not. Oh, Ross, you little cheater. I would not. I would absolutely not wear my cum shirt on stream. It doesn't leave my room. What is your favorite episode of Yo Gabba Gabba? I like the one where they sing. Me too. Oh, shit, y'all. Look at all... oh, it's already full of resources? Oh. Oh, guys, I'm thinking that Rock Island might have been the move. My favorite Yo Gabba Gabba one is where they sing that song where it's like... excuse me, you're excused. Excuse me, you're excused. You guys know what I'm talking about? Y'all fuck with Yo Gabba Gabba at all? It's a... DJ Lance Rock is a fucking... icon. That guy is fucking legendary. Like, if you guys don't fuck with DJ Lance Rock, then unfortunately I'd have to ban you from my streams. That guy is like, oh my god, I think this is like the first iron I've ever fucking found on this server. I don't know if they did a crossover with Blue's Clues. Oh, this is fucking sick, guys. Like, I haven't even gotten up to see, like, the main part of Rock Island, but, I'm already seeing lots of resources here. Looks like it's rich with now I see how these dudes felt back in the day when they would show up to a new land with all that was full of resources, and like, we have to take it. That sounded like I was just, basically, pro- colonization. That is not what I meant. Let's pretend that I didn't say that. I have my hardcover in 10 out of 10 story, only one spelling error I've noticed. Really? Wait, what spelling error? Is there really a spelling error in the book? Unsub and said, I just wanted to pop in for a sec. I got to edit my own Minecraft-related thing. Well, thank you, Unsubbin. Unsubbin is one of my mods who y'all should go, despite his name, y'all should go sub to. He's cool. He makes cool videos. Also, oh, I do look like a little ghost boy, but wow. Oh, wow. I just got to remember. Well, automatic saving is now disabled. I have to remember how to get back, so I'm just gonna make like a little stone tower right here, you know, and okay guys, here's the move. Ready? See this? This points in the direction to get back to the main area, so all I have to do is just get here and then sail that way and I'll be back in the main area. See? Boom. No, not the one on the back of the book. What was the typo? Also, do you guys enjoy the first time chat from viewer? You fell off. Thank you, Vabman16. I wouldn't debate that. Thank you. It is a cool backdrop. It's brand new. I just got it on Amazon. Okay, well let's check out Rock Island. What spelling error is in the book? I would like to get this fixed. Wow. Wow. Look at this little place. Ain't she cute? Look, we got these little, what is this, a tulip? Yep, we got little tulips. Wow, got some rocks. We got a lot of like empty rock area. I see a bumblebee. This is sick, this is perfect for starting anew and people won't come bother me over here. It is kind of like a magic show type background. Whoa, guys! I think I'm liking Rock Island. It kind of turns into like a savanna over here. I've never seen one of those biomes. Let's see, let's check it out. Oh fuck! I thought this was wood. I thought that somebody had already been here. I will be devastated if I find out someone already has like claimed this area. What the fuck is this? Why did it? Oh, I guess that's how savanna trees look. Is this like just a big crevasse? No, okay, cool. Let's just go explore over here real quick and then I'll start my new Minecraft life. Matt Kronos is looking for you. Well, that's too bad. What the oh shit. Oh, I almost fell down a big old hole. There's a lot of resources here. I'm liking what I'm seeing, you know? Look at this dude over here, praise the God. Hey, thank you Diet Mail for the 10 bucks. You're such a sweetheart as always. Okay. Also, I just woke up from a nap, so I'm a little groggy still. Wow, this is cool. This is my new house. Come here, boy. These are like also like I haven't seen any animals yet. Like where the spawn is, the regular spawn, there's like no animals. Like there's no resources. So, come here, boy. Now I can actually, like, make food and shit, you know? Don't kill sheep. I need to make a bed, bro. Suck it, bro. Come here, bro. I need to build a sword. I'll let him live. I'll spare him, just so he remembers. I don't want him to forget. But you die. I hunger for lamb. Matt from Markiplier? Yeah, God did make this island for me. And look at all these little, like, it looks like there's a lot of shit going on underground here. I'm gonna have fun on this here little island. So here's the spelling error I noticed on page 10. Narrowly missing pedestrians and making crank phone calls. Shouldn't it be prank phone calls? So now I demand editor credits. No, it actually is crank phone calls. We use the word crank because that's an older term for prank phone calls, and we thought that it was funnier to say crank phone calls instead of prank phone calls. So you're wrong, actually, so that's too bad. What's the island's name? Well, I was calling it just Rock Island, but now it looks like it's a lot more than that. So how does that person not know what crank phone calls means? Like Friday Night Cranks, you guys remember? Crank gameplays? Like that, yeah, that's Casey Rudd said crank calls are before all of y'all's time. Y'all need to get with the program. That's true. That's absolutely true. Shout out Casey from my last stream. Childhood friend I reconnected with. I was very drunk on that stream with Trevor. I hope that was enjoyable. I got really, really hammered and crossfaded. So I apologize for my misconduct. But ooh, this is awesome. There's animals everywhere. This is the move, man. Like, I feel like I can really start over here and really ooh, Justin's here. Really enjoy it. I don't want to invite anyone over to my island yet. Until, you know. I want to map this area out later. But I feel like maybe I should build my house over here. Like, this little rock area looks pretty nice. Oh, I should use the axe to kill them. Oops. Y'all know I'd do it just to piss you off. Okay, this is a nice little spot for a house. Like, I don't need anything complex yet. Just a little beginner house. Hey, do bees attack you? Can bees attack? Hey, buddy. What can I do with honey? Can I, like, collect it? Oh, shit! No! Oh, fuck. I should have... I spit all over myself. I'm a fucking idiot. What did I think was gonna happen? Okay. Well, it looks like I'm safe. Okay. I'll build my little house. Right here. My first little house will be up here on top of this rock. Rock mansion on Rock Island. Yeah, I could build it out of rock. You know what? That's exactly what I'm gonna do. I usually do wood. This time I'm gonna do it. I wonder if Matt's dad gets mad if Matt says whoopsies. Yeah, probably. I remember when I was a kid, I was taking tennis lessons and my neighbor was teaching me, and like it was super, like, I wanted my neighbor to respect me and think I was like this like macho dude. And I remember I missed the ball once and I said oopsie daisy, and I got really embarrassed. Okay. I'm gonna build myself a little rock mansion. I think should I do it up here or should I do it down there? And that I'll do it down here in this little rock plane. Let's see. This looks fitting. This looks like a perfect place for a little rock house, you know? Yes, yes. Oh yes. Okay, let's just go ahead and start. Just something simple, you know. Just the basics. It's all I need right now. So, wool. I don't have enough for a bed yet, but I saw more sheep over there. So, I will make a very basic house. Like, we talking night one. I mean, I'm this is my big reset. This is the grand reset. I can't believe that person is calling me out and so cocky about it too. Just so yeah, I deserve editor credits. No, you were wrong, buddy. Look it up. What shaders does the server use? I forgot, but Trevor customized this shader himself because he knows how to do that stuff. So yeah. So that's pretty epic of Trevor, just in my opinion. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys one of the sickest Minecraft houses you've probably ever seen. I don't want to brag, but this will be pretty neat. Hey, Toadstos, thank you for gifting 5 subs. And Ben Harmon, sorry I missed yours. Thank you for the sub. MandaBear72, thank you for the sub. Sorry, I paused for a second because I thought I felt an earthquake. Annabelle Nancy, thank you for the sub. Diet Mayo with the 10 bucks said, manifesting next week would be better for you, buddy. Thank you. That means a lot. I've had a rough February so far, but today was really good with the video we shot. I had an excellent day. Flintstones ass looking house. Should I even like build it more over to this side, or just literally just make it like this big? Damn it, I should have brought some glass. He's 26. That's right, I'm 26. My birthday happened since since last time. And no, that was not you and my mother. No, that I'm done. Oh god. I hope no skeletons come out, dude. Skeletons fucking suck. Yeah, this is we about to have the best house in Minecraft history. Might fill that. Yeah, I'm gonna fill that in. Yeah, it needs some windows. Sure. I'm not gonna die of exposure, bro. Here's what I'll do. I'll make a stove real quick. Do I stop my OP powers? Cause I need to eat. I need to cook my food. Skeletons, look in the mirror. That's not funny. I know I'm starving. There goes Justin. I had a lot of exposure therapy today for my vomit phobia. So, Casey, if you're still in the chat, do you remember my vomit phobia? Yeah, I still got that, but not as bad. So it was pretty bad. This man is about to die and lose Cock Island. No, I'm not. And I'm not calling it Cock Island. Well, now that I've said that, that means that everyone is going to refer to it as Cock Island. So I guess now it's Cock Island. So welcome to Cock Island, everyone. We have some fun here. We build. How did that phobia even start? I don't know, actually. How my eyes burn. I don't know. I don't remember. Something, I guess, early childhood trauma. I don't know.
Man, look at this dude over here, praise God.
Oh,
man.
Shit. Johnny Fantastico, thanks for the $5. You sweet. Matt, how are you planning to brave the elements in your island life on Cock Island? Well, you're about to see. Watch and learn, okay? We're just going for the basics here. See that? Boom. Man discovering fire. Wasn't it third grade your friend threw up on you? No, I don't think so. I talked to my mom about it more, and what I think it actually is my dad had this, I forgot what it's called. He had some issue with his throat, where he would, like, choke every now and then at dinner, and then have to, like, puke for 10 minutes. And as a kid, I thought, like, my dad was dying, and I would hear him, like, in the bathroom, like, and I'd be like, Dad, are you okay? And, it really scared the shit. I mean, honestly, I think that that's probably where it came from. Cock Island is not a white supremacist ethno state. Let's stop spreading those rumors right away. I will not stand for people to say such things about Cock Island. Because I'm really vibing with Cock Island at the moment. I won't lie. Like, this place is pretty cool. I feel very lucky to have discovered this. And also, it's still kind of close to spawn, so I gotta go find another sheep. Okay. Okay. I could put a little bed over here. Would you look at that? I need to make a... What the... Oh. Okay, got some of that. Got some of that. Oh, baby. You'd love to see it. Why do my eyes burn so bad? Dads always do puke so loud. That's so true. Like when dads puke, it's loud. Annabelle Nancy tipped $10 and said, "No tax fraud this year, Matthew. You have a great stream." Hey, I'm trying. Hey, but you know me. You know me. Can't always stop me from a little tax fraud. This is gonna be a great clip to use. Smash cut when I'm arrested for tax fraud later this year. I could see that clip on Twitter now with the dun dun dun. You know. Curb your tax fraud. I have not committed tax fraud. Just say that out loud. Clitoris Bay? Absolutely not. I'm not naming it after some nonsensical imaginary thing. Okay. So now that we have that, let's see. I'm gonna go ahead and make some sticks so I can make some torches. See that, guys? See that? Yeah, I think you do. I need to go find another sheep. Boom. And I need to go find a little, well, first I have to eat. What's the status on the Arceus Let's Play? Do you guys like it? Do you want to see more? Cock Island is a manly name for men. Yo, I'm Spage. Thank you for the sub. I don't know how to say that. This is like the ultimate, like, a kid on the morning announcements at school gets to, like, read some stuff out, and, that you know, like, gets all the names wrong. This is, like, the ultimate version of that. Are you guys doing Elden Ring? I actually don't know what that is. What is Elden Ring? Oh, shit, wait. I can't get lost already. I came from this way. Okay. Alright, I need a fucking sheep. Scream if you see a sheep. More like, name it Cock Island so these dudes keep its name out their mouth. Well, unfortunately, knowing the guys on this server, that's not gonna happen. Hey, thank you for the bits. Yo mama, they're very funny, okay? That's not very funny. Hey, little bitch. we have a little fun around here. Where is... I need a little sheep. I'm... Hey! But is this gonna give me black wool? Whoa, I hit him. Can I mix wool to make... Can I mix wool to make a bed? Or do I need... That has no drip Watson. What the fuck are you talking about? Okay, I'll kill this guy over here. Ooh, egg. I'm really loving Cock Island so far, guys. Like, I no complaints. Bitch. Fucked him up. Okay. There's plenty of wildlife here. Boom. Okay, now I can build a bed. And you. Yeah. I think so. I'll plant some flowers outside my house to make it extra pretty. What the fuck is that? What the hell is that? I saw... Oh, okay, it's a pre-spawn village. Thank God. I thought that it... Right? That's a pre-spawn village, right? No, there's a boat down there. Holy shit. No. No! Wait, is this a pre-spawn village? Hold on. I gotta be quiet, guys. I gotta sneak.
Dude over here, praise God, man.
Whoa. So this is a village. That's cool. So I got a fucking... Ooh, melon. Fuck yeah. Oh my God. Dude, guys, Cock Island's fucking awesome. This is the best thing I could have asked for. Oh my God. Okay. Well, I'm gonna go back and build my bed. I keep thinking I'm feeling an earthquake. There was an earthquake the other morning, and I was actually right, because usually I am like, oh, was that an earthquake? And then there was nothing. But this time... I woke up and I was like, oh, it's a real earthquake. Hey, bud. I hate to kill all these animals, but it was like a 3.0 earthquake. Shook my room. My little socks were rocked straight off of my little piggies. My TV in my room was going. I'm not an imperialist, okay? Stop. Matt refuses to finish the railroad Watson. You know what? That project was just going nowhere. You know, at some point you got to cut your losses. What's even the point anymore over there? You know. Okay, let's build a bed, and then I'm gonna go grab something to drink, because I'm a thirsty young boy. Ooh, look at that. Guys, can you believe that? Where should I put my bed? Nice, clean, white linen sheets. Nice male living space. Your house sucks. I told you it's like a day one house. I never said I'm gonna build something nice. I'm trying to do it correctly this time. I want to establish my fucking, you know, setup on my new land away from everyone. Yandere San, thank you for the bits. Johnny Fantastico gave $5. Matt, how's Michael Jackson? What do you think about the Ukraine/Russia tension? I was thinking you might know a bit, given that you were a government official. Well, I can't speak too much on it due to that, but I do think that, what's today, the 11th? On the 13th, Russia will invade Ukraine, unfortunately. And we'll see where it goes from there. Biden will issue some pretty intense sanctions on Russia. And let's see. Michael Jackson's great. My fish, he's fantastic. Should I? Oh, no. Hey, Kelly. No, I didn't mean away from everyone. I just... Everyone's griefing me. I build a house. I have fun building my house. They destroy it. This is a goated with the sauce moment. Can I... Oh, yes. Guys, you see this great male living space? This really is like... Sorry, that was, I was starting to take a nap earlier, so I turned an alarm on for 1 hour. Cool guy Rory, thanks for the $1. Mad at my 18 years on Earth, I've thrown up at least 300 times due to cyclic vomiting. Want to be friends? No, I don't. Snowy Pies, thanks for the sub. Yandere-san, Mr. Pyro Pancake, Jimbo, thanks for the shit, and Tinsen Ho, thank you for the dollar. Okay, can this reset my spawn point though? I know it's not nighttime yet, but I'll rearrange this once it's, you know. Where'd all my stone go? Did I really run out of stone already? Hello, Maddie. It's Sam. Is that really you, Sam? Or is that someone pretending to be my sister? You know that subreddit where it's... Is it just called Male Living Spaces? Where it's like a... It'll be like a dude's apartment and it's literally just like... Like a mattress on the floor. Like a box spring mattress just on the floor. With like a TV sitting like across the room on the floor, and then maybe like a folding lawn chair. If I need proof that that's really my sister. Cause some of you are trolls, some of you are dang dirty trolls, and I will not have it on my Minecraft server. Sam, are you there? I don't think that's really my sister. Text me if that's really you. Otherwise, it's a dang dirty troll! And I do not tolerate dang dirty trolls. I don't. Oh shit. I'm just trying to place this block on top, but okay, that's not gonna work. Oh, god damn it! It's me. Ask a question only I would know. Okay, Sam, if it's really you, oh god, well now I just can't think of anything, so, you know, damn slanderous trolls! Sam, Sam, what's your credit card number? Ask something about the book. She helped. Yeah, but that's a lot. Some of you guys have read the book too. Oh, also, I hope you guys like the new emotes. I've been watching the Geno Samuel doc due to y'all's recommendation. I can't believe all the shit that happens. It's crazy, right? Sam, real question is what is the island off the coast of Charleston that we go. Chill at when I visit home. I'll leave that for light. This is looking pretty nice. Alright, Sam, what's mom's darkest secret? Put a little nightlight over my bed. This is looking great, guys. Okreon, thanks for the one bit. That's amazing. Annex 0001, thank you for the sub. So, okay, she got that one right. Sam, what's your dog's name? No, that's too easy. That's public. Let me think of something that What is, it's a fucking bug in my house. Sam, what is, yeah, I really am thinking. This is, just text me. Hey, Platypi, thanks for gifting my potential sister, a tier one sub. If she ain't text you, I think it's a dang dirty troll. I think so, too. I'm getting sick and tired of these dang dirty trolls! Yeah, Chris Chan's, court, shit got extended to, like, July. Again. That's ridiculous. Chris Chan's just rotting away in a prison cell right now. Granted, Chris had sex with her mother, but... Well, wait, no. Now there's another Sam in the chat. Now there's Sam Watson? That's not... What's going on here, guys? What's going on? Listening to Super Mega Cast while trying to sleep. Just want to say hi. It's 5 a.m. in Ireland. Well, you should get some sleep. It's late for you. It's like the third or fourth time it's gotten pushed back. Is Chris Chan's mom hot? No. I'm not answering that. She's a beautiful woman. Okay, well this is my little hut. Don just asked me where I am, but I'm gonna be honest, I don't want anyone coming over here yet. You know, it's like I kinda like my little area. Ooh, look at this little purple flower. That's nice. God, it's so hard keeping up with the chat and trying to play Minecraft. Got her. Got him. Now there's Sam accounts popping up. I don't like this. Can I make roasted watermelon? See, I'm not getting a text from my sister, so that's all I'm saying. You know, the proof is in the pudding, as they say. And the pudding is quite fresh today. Matt, it's me, your window stalker. Your room is messy. I know it's a little messy, but thank you for the pointer. I'll clean it up. I haven't read my Jordan Peterson in quite a bit. Kind of starting to forget some of the points he's made, which is bad. I need to brush up. Yes, it is a Sum 41 shirt. Damn dirty trolls. I'm sick and tired of these damn dirty trolls. Nothing will ever beat, nothing will ever fucking beat Chris Chan holding the Transformer, making the video saying, I'm not gay. Like the 10 minute, no. That's the video where Chris Chan says that they are gay. I'm talking, the one who's like, I am straight. I love boobs. China. The aversion to saying vagina is one of my favorites. I am straight. I do not like men. I like women. Me at Thanksgiving dinner to my parents. If you want the trolling to stop, admit you're gay. That's I'm gonna go get a drink. Da na 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 na.
Storming through the party like my name was El Nino.
Mr. Lube XD, thanks for the sub. Did I get a text from my sister? Oh, I did, and she said it. Okay, it is my sister. I'll mod you, Sam. Whoops. What's your username? Say something again, sister, so I can mod you. Is DMX in that music video? Did you know Chris Chan was going to be in Smiling Friends as a grease puddle? Obviously, the fuck stuff happened. I did not know that, but I think we've talked about this. Chris Chan actually, we had contacted, and okay, I modded you, Sam. Chris Chan was in the process of designing a shirt for Super Mega, which unfortunately now will never come out. So yeah, the Chris Chan shirt will not be happening. But oh damn, so many people just missed that legendary thing I just said because some ads played. Man, I guess if you were subbed, you would have seen it like the rest of the subs. And now I'm not repeating that story. Gotcha. Stupid fucking. Ooh. Well, now I'm nervous because my sister's watching. Okay, I'm gonna go mining. Oh, how I love my mic. How I love... I just bought a new mixer and everything, so hopefully it should be better, but... God damn. Yeah, so Chris Chan was working on a shirt for us that didn't end up happening. Jimbo said, Matt, look out, it's a creeper. Ha, just kidding. It's only an emoji. Just a little prank. Okay, Jimbo, you got me pretty good there. That's also a really cool username. How the fuck did you get the username Jimbo? Hello, this is Trevor. Thanks for the sub. ChickenLips324, thanks for the bits. Okay, I need to go mining now. So, I bet you Windows is the issue. Yeah, it is. Fix your mic if you like dick. I fixed my mic before I even saw that comment. That's not fair. What's y'all's favorite Sum 41 song? I'll keep a little bit of wood on me. Some torches on me. A little stone never hurt. I'll keep some sticks. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Oh, what's up, Trevor? Matt, fix your setup. It's really bad right now. No, it's not, dude. I don't want to say it. Trevor, I don't want to hear it, dude. I just called you my sister's name because she's in the chat. Now I'm nervous and now you're telling me my setup sucks. Okay, that's... Why? That's so annoying. No, okay, fix it if you like dick. Fix your mic if you're gay. No. I fixed it before I saw both of those comments. Kuno Cools, Cool Beans, thank you for the sub. Okay, I'm just organizing my shit so we can go out and get some shit. All right, let's go mining, y'all. Let's go fucking become miners. Nope. Let's go mining. Let's see. Keep your mic fixed if you're gay. Back to the mines, fellas. Oh, wow. What do we have down here? Oh, wow. Oh, actually, it's getting dark. Does that matter? Somebody will set it to daytime. Well, I don't know how much good shit I'll find down here, because now, apparently, they made all the iron above ground, mainly. Wait a second. Is that water? Oh, okay. I was about to say, has someone been here? Matt, if you could only save one Sam or Trevor, who would it be? That's hard. Heyo, I'm the SW that painted you that massive penis painting in one of your mailrooms. Is that the one that... Is it, like, this big? And it's, like, just a cock and balls, and it's got, like, a cool colored background? Because if so, then it's actually, it's hanging up in our bathroom in the Super Megaplex. We hung that one up. I'm not muted. Stop it. You guys suck. You guys fucking... What other streamer has to deal with this shit? They just get to talk to their audience and have some fun. And I'm just getting gaslit left and right every fucking time I sit down and stream. I'm getting gaslit. I'm not muted. Streamers aren't usually muted. Exactly. That means you can hear me. Gotcha. You just played yourself. Look at this iron, guys. Is that? Oh wait, zinc. What the fuck? What the fuck is zinc for? I hear spiders. Not a big fan. I hear some scary monsters and nice sprites. You guys know what that reference is? You guys ever heard of a little band called Skrillex? Which rapper was the biggest inspiration to me? Drake. Oh damn, I'm gonna have to bust out the ukulele and play some Drake in a minute. Chill Fortress said, Matt, I want to let you know that last week I started the Super Mega Podcast from episode 1. It helps me sleep at night, except when a funny joke makes me lol. Nah. Thank you. That's very sweet. Matt, your nice socks are untied. Tiefling twit tweet. Thank you for gifting those subs. It's very sweet. Bera Bear, thanks for the sub. Jerry West 98 has gifted a sub. When I think of people born in 1998, I'm like, oh man, they're so young. And then I remember they're like 20. They could be like 24 right now. Now that I'm a big old man, I'm 26, guys. Isn't that crazy? You know, it feels like just yesterday I was a scrawny little 19 year old on the. Ooh, that spatial audio fucks me up. I was just a scrawny little 19-year-old on the internet, making Let's Plays, and now look at me. Now I'm a fucking big, strong, 26-year-old man. Creeping closer to my 30s. It's really scary. I don't like it. It makes me feel like an old man, and my time has passed. Right, YouTubers don't... YouTubers can be young, right? I mean, like 26, right? Like, YouTubers don't have to be all, like 19, 20 to be cool. I mean, you guys love a little 26 year old, right? My time is not up. Is Ryan in the chat? Hey, Hunger for More, thanks for the sub. Okay, I'm kind of scared to go down here. So what I'm gonna do is, fuck, I'm just gonna do it. This is pretty cool. Is that zinc? Okay, what does iron look like now? They changed, like, the sprites and shit. Don't forget to check your coordinates, Matt. You don't want to be getting lost now. Is it F3? No, it's... Yeah. Someone screenshot my coordinates. Thank you. Okay, now I won't get lost. Seriously, I'm really gonna be calling back to. No, I'm right by my spawn point. I'm fine. I mean, PewDiePie is like 90, and he's one of the big. That's true. That's true. You know what? Aaron Hansen, 40. Danny, what? He's pushing 80 now. I'm only 26. You know, it's all right. Matt, why did you send me your penis in the United States Postal Service? That's not even possible, dude. Hurricane Tortilla said, I wish I was friends with you and Ryan. Cool, bro. How about you make some friends in real life? I'm sorry, that was uncalled for. Is that Zinc? I know Aaron's 34. I was just joking. The only person's age I know for sure is Danny, and that's 76. Okay, I've been postponing going down to these mines out of fear. So I'm just gonna do it. Ooh, iron! That's what iron looks like. There we go. Come to Papa. Which Spider-Man would I smash the most? Andrew Garfield, probably. He played Spider-Man, right? Andrew Garfield's a little cutie. I just watched the social. So Trevor had never been. Trevor's never seen The Social Network, and I was like, dude, you've never fucking seen The Social Network? And he's like, no, man, no, I haven't seen it. So I, the last night he was here, I made him fucking watch The Social Network all the way through, and I hope he enjoyed it. Do you like it, Trevor? Are you still in the chat, or did you just pop in just to say hi? Here's what I'm gonna do. Wait, hold on, stop. Give me just one. How do I just choose one torch? Stop. Oh, god damn it. Okay. There we go. That's the move right there, see? My eyes are fucking burning and watering tonight. Ow. Andrew Garfield's pretty good as Eduardo Sovereign and The Social Network. I saw that what's his name? Sorkin. Adam Sorkin? Andy Sorkin? His name is, the writer of The Social Network, said he has like another script like he could do for a sequel, and it's not Andy Serkis. Aaron Sorkin, yeah. And he wants David Fincher to direct it, which I think would be cool because I really like that movie. I don't know if there's anything good down here. You guys think I should keep going this way? My light is not as bright as the sun, okay? That's legitimately such an exaggeration that it pisses me off. I can rotate it a little bit. I really like this new backdrop I got on Amazon. That's true. If I put my sunglasses on, it cannot hurt my eye. Oh, shit. Oh, there's my sunglasses. Oh, you guys can like see my chat. Look at all that. You guys could see all my personal information. If I pull something up, like, hold on a second. Give me a second. Sorry, I was adjusting something. Let's see. Yeah, I gotta put on these sunglasses because the future's too bright for me. Okay, I'll go down here. I'll see what's in store for. Okay, this looks like a dead end, maybe. Oh, no. Daddy found some coal, so. Hold on, I'm just checking something. Sorry, my mom just texted me. Never mind. Okay. Sorry about that. My mom was messaging me on iMessage or something like that. I love these little like glowing stones they added. How cool is that, guys? Okay. Just get a little coal. Someone's eventually gonna find me, but I for the time being, I'll enjoy my private little cock island. I feel like Dr. Disrespect with these sunglasses on. Does he still stream? Is he still disrespecting? Is he still out here doing his disrespecting and doctoring? And I don't actually think that guy's a doctor. I don't think he has a doctorate. Okay. A little coal never hurt anybody. Except the environment. Just kidding. That shit's not real. This is not the texture pack. This is a shader. It's not part of the update. It's a shader that Trevor customized. How do I get out of here? Wait, where did I come from? Where did I go? Where did I come from, Cotton Eye Joe? Hold on. God, it's really hard to fucking see like Minecraft when I have sunglasses on. Okay, how did I get in here? Oh fuck. Right, it was through. Oh shit. Was it? Oh no. How did I? There's no way I just got lost in here. Like, I literally just came in here. There's no way. D Garcia 122. Thank you for the. Never mind. Richmond 97. Thank you for the bits. Fishies Jr., thanks for the sub. Did I just really get lost like this quick? I didn't need to drop a torch because I literally just went down like a single crack. And now I don't know where the exit to this crack is. Oh, I'm stupid. It's right there. All of this talk about crack is making me thirsty. And by thirsty, I mean I'm having a hankering to smoke crack cocaine. Because I have a bad, bad crack addiction. It's not even funny. It's not funny. I shouldn't even joke about it. It's bad. Okay. Guys, this is pretty epic. I found some iron. Nutty Putty moment. That's fucked. That shit is terrifying. You know what? Maybe I've been wanting to do some YouTube streams because one of my favorite things to do is just watch YouTube. And I was like, why don't I just watch YouTube? Then you guys can watch it with me. Formal Squidiot, that's true. Bad crack addictions don't exist. Only good ones. Many resources this is. Maybe I'll watch. We can watch a scary YouTube video later on the Nutty Putty Cave shit. I don't want to just be like a React streamer. But I genuinely think it'll be really fun just to like watch YouTube videos and just react, because I love watching weird YouTube videos. I have a whole playlist of crazy, crazy shit. You guys wouldn't even believe how quirky I can get. I'm worried that the shit I watch might just be too boring, because I watch a lot of videos on. What recently I've been watching a lot about like shipwrecks, like ships that sank, not like ancient or like old ships. I mean like ones from like the 60s or 70s. Like I like watching disaster videos a lot, like videos on like incidents that have happened. Grumpy Cat, yeah. I should make a That potato gun Marisa has is awesome. I want some copper blocks. I might rebuild my house out of copper. Yeah, looking up a keyword and then sorting by upload date is my favorite way to find good YouTube videos. That sounds really close. See, I don't want to do that on stream also, because I don't want to, like... I would love to do that on stream, but I just don't want to, you know, it's like if I watch some, like, 12-year-old cover Three Doors Down, and then a bunch of people in my chat go and comment on that kid's video. You know, it's like, I don't want to be like a bully. So I'd rather watch it and bully in my own privacy. I do have a big playlist. Oh, there's a zombie. In Minecraft, zombies. Okay. So down there, I see creeper, spider, creeper. Okay, I feel like they made caves way harder. Like, way fucking harder. But yeah, I mean, like, even when I tell chat, like, don't go comment on this video, like, I love sharing videos with you guys. Especially, it's like a hidden gem. But I say, please don't go spam the video with, like, Matt Watson sent me. And then there's always a bunch of comedians that do. And it just kind of ruins it. Just because it's like, you know. I really like sharing videos, though. Like I have so many hidden gems that have, like, 30 views that I really want to share with you guys. But I just don't want to... Because, see, then it crosses the line into, like, harassment if people start going and just, you know, commenting on... Oh, shit, wait, what? Oh. Whew. Thought I was lost for a second. Dad wants me. I know Dad wants me. I don't want Dad. The E39, thank you for gifting that sub.
Matt, has your opinion on In-N-Out Burgers changed since 2016?
Yeah. I like it more now. You know, it was just played up too much. Whatever you do not ask Matt Watson what he did August 12, 2009. What happened? What did I do August 12, 2009? Is that when the Shane Dawson video came out? I'm just gonna take a wild shot in the dark here. I say that's the upload date of the Shane Dawson video. Johnny Fantastico, thank you for gifting that sub. Can I make anything out of zinc? Oh yeah. Matt blinks, Jesus, I almost got lost.
Yeah.
It do be true, though. Hey, that's a good one, man. I love seeing these new emotes in the chat that my buddy Jav made. Super cool. All these beautiful little triangle guy emojis. Lots of hidden gems are on accounts made with Google+, so it's hard since it was sure their actual name. Yeah, I don't ever want to dox anyone. Like, I want to enjoy funny videos from afar. And, the problem is when I bring the audience into it, then I get people that end up harassing those people, and then it's, like, just not cool. I want to watch a video on the Nutty Putty cave now. That shit's scary. Maybe I'll order some food. I'm pretty hungry, so maybe I'll order some food, and when it gets here, we can watch some... can all watch some YouTube videos. Where's my cellular device?
That cellular will be the death of us, I swear.
You guys remember that song? Matt Watson, can we have streaks on Snapchat? Is it fucking 2017? Have I seen the Steel Reserve 40-ounce review? No, I haven't, but Steel Reserves... Steel Reserve is like the quickest. If you just want to get fucked up really fast, Steel Reserve is a great. Moist Critical reacts to YouTube all the time, and no one goes to harass. Yeah, well, if you guys are cool. And when I say you guys, I mean it's literally like six of you, and there's 1,000 people watching. So all 994 of you are cool. Six of you suck. And you know who you are. I bet you know who you are. I actually don't know who you are, but I you know who you are. Thank you, Annabelle, Nancy. Good night. Matt, you and Ryan should do a new collab with Game Grumps. Yeah, I would love to play like a Mario Party rematch or something with them. Yeah, Steel Reserve is nasty. Steel Reserve is, I'm really tempted though to go buy a Steel Reserve right now. So, don't tempt me. It's Friday night. I had a bad fucking last 10 days. Don't fucking tempt me to go buy a goddamn Steel Reserve. I want to see Super Mega with Wubby. Yeah, that'll happen. Matt, did you wash your stinky ass today? Yes, I did, actually. I woke up at 6:30 in the morning and washed my ass. Four Loko review. You blocked me on Twitter for like 2 years. You know, I know it's me you're adding. Heather Ray XO. Heather, I hate to break it to you. I don't recognize your username. And if I had you blocked, it's probably for good reason. Whatever you do, don't ask where Matt and Ryan were on January 6th, 20. Don't. Just don't. Man, I don't want to get a Steel Reserve, man. That shit's going to get me too drunk on stream. And you know what happens when I get fucking drunk on stream? It's awesome, isn't it? I like getting drunk on stream. It's fun. But I fucking, I wake up the next morning. I'm like, what did I say on stream? Did I slur my words? Did I look stupid? Swantru, thanks for the sub. And Raging Souls 23. And Chill Fortress. And Prestige Full. Malt Liquor Matt. Maybe I'll go buy a 40. Maybe I'll do Edward. Maybe I'll do Steve 40 hands instead of Edward 40 hands, where I'll tape the 40 to my hand while I play Minecraft. Matt needs to focus on building some more stone houses. That's true. I met you and Ryan on Omegle in 2016 on accident. We were both under the furry tag making fun of people. My mic didn't work, so I couldn't say hi. That's funny. I do wanted some food. Love you too, MickMatt117. Wow, 6 years of following the podcast. It's just crazy to me that it's been that long. Hot glue them to your hands. Guys, I burned my cock and balls so fucking bad yesterday because thank you, Dumb BV3. We have like a bidet at the office, but it's like not like a bougie one. It's like just like a little cheap one off Amazon where it's like you twist a knob and it sprays water. You just hook it up to like the plumbing tube. And something's wrong with the plumbing at the Super Megaplex, and it literally it's only shot out cold water ever. And this time I was like, all right, let me spray my asshole. It shot out boiling fucking water. And the water at the Plex gets hot. Really, really, really hot. And like it gets like scalding hot. Like the hot water heater settings are fucked. And it sprayed my ass. And it was so hot, I instinctively like jumped up like this, which exposed my cock and balls from the back. And the stream of boiling water went from my asshole in a beeline directly down my gooch, my balls, and my dick. And literally all day, like yesterday, like my dick was red. It actually felt like the sensation of, you know, when you bite pizza that's too hot and the roof of your mouth gets burnt. That's exactly what it felt like, but on my penis. And it legitimately was so not fun because I was having a really bad day yesterday. And I was like, this is the last fucking thing I need today. So I'm really actually terrified to use the bidet now because there was like nothing that actually prompted that. It just fucking happened. So I guys, make sure you don't ask what Matt did on August 6, 1945. What happened on August 6, 1940? Okay, that's when we bombed Japan. Took me a second. I did freak like Freddy. It really did suck, though. I burned my gooch and my nuts and everything. Do I have a favorite block on Minecraft? Yeah, they got rid of it. It was Sponge. I really like Sponge. Or maybe they got it back. I want to make some iron. I mean, some raw copper. Make some copper blocks. Jimbo asks, when am I going to release my next NFT? They're coming, guys. I got a collab coming with Bored Ape that is... Okay, now you guys are throwing dates out when I'm like, was that when I uploaded a funny YouTube video in middle school, or is that when like a horrible shooting happened? Heather Ray, it's because I was trying to be funny in 2016, jokingly told you to block me and you did, and then about 2 years ago you unblocked me. Oh, yeah, I was a dick back then. I was really trying to space from the Markiplier fans, and I was just blocking everyone, so I apologize. Happy birthday, Chameleon 2001. I turned 21 today. Can I get a smooch? Wait, they didn't remove Sponge? It used to get rid of water, which I thought was really cool. Mick Matt 117, 1,000 bits. Holy shit! Okay, Matt, like LA has changed you, bro. P.S. Do you watch Hassan Piker? Yeah, I tune in from time to time. We know Hassan. He's a sweet boy, and our podcast set is. Actually, this week is completely, like, it's almost done. We have, like, two more lights to set up. But it's, Hassan is going to be one of the first guests. I realized the other day I started watching Super Mega when I was going into middle school. Now I'm in my first year of uni. Wow. That's crazy. Did you guys just see, like, me die inside a little bit? Like the realization? It was really, like, the realization of, like, if I've been doing this that long, why do I have, like... Not like so every all the other YouTubers are rich, and it's just like, what have I been doing with, like, why have I handled my money so poorly? Stupid. Shifting perspective said lame. Hassan sucks. Well, how about you shift your perspective one more time, buddy? He's a close friend of me and Ryan. We are incredibly close. We talk every day. He lets us come over to his mansion, which has a candy room, by the way. Notch isn't the only one. And his candy, unlike Notch, is not stale. Whatever you do, don't ask Matt what hotel he was staying at on June 17th, 1960. What are these? I don't know what these dates are. Are you guys making dates up? June 17th, 1972. Well, now I gotta look that up. Oh, okay, it's Watergate. That's funny. Hotel Cecil, they closed it down and they're like rebranding that shit. I should probably make a door too so I can escape monsters when I need to. Can you make stone doors? Bro, you should have a Freddy Dread concert in Minecraft. That'd be epic. Yeah, might have to do that. Can I make a stone door? No. I don't think I can, Lieutenant Dan. And then also, what do these fucking... Oh, it's not how you do it. Wait, how do you make copper blocks? Do I really need, like... Do I need... Oh, I need that much? To make one fucking copper block? Sure, I'll try it, but... That's dumb. That is, yeah, a little bit stupid in my opinion. Hassan didn't say that about me. He did not say I'm stinky at Minecraft and need to get better. I know he wouldn't say that. So stop. Stop spreading fucking lies. What happened? Stop giving me these dates because I like feel very compelled to look them up. April 14th, Lincoln was shot. Okay. Hey, Matt, what's your favorite deep Chris? Oh, what's up, Jav? Tropic? It's the fella who made the emotes of the triangle guys for me. I like ...1999 She, I think is what it's called. It's like 1999. Ignore the trolls. Yeah, I don't think I will, Punky Clown. That's a very troll thing to say. I'm gonna order food. Whatever you do, don't ask Matt what he did on November 22nd, 1963 on the 6th floor of the Texas School Book Depository. What? What is that? Yoshimi Lee said 4/18/2022. What does that mean? I don't like it when you... When people put future dates, it's very ominous. I don't like it. What does that mean? Stop it. When you say April 18th, 2022, Matt, and that's it, what does that mean? Are you coming to kill me that day? Listen, if you're coming to kill me, I just got to say, there's a lot of other YouTubers that I think you should kill over me. Just because... You know, I'm not that big. You know, like there's a lot of YouTubers that are much bigger that, you know, you could make a much you know, like bigger deal. You kill me, no one's gonna care. Stop saying future dates. I don't like it. What should I order? Actually, I don't even need my headphones on right now because. I don't need my headphones because no one's talking to me and I can't hear myself talk when I have my headphones on. Order some bitches. Yeah, I don't think so. Can I make my camera bigger? Sorry, let me just make my camera big. God damn it, Bobby. Hold on. Got a little tunes playing. How's that, guys? I God damn it! Stop with the fucking. My mic is muted. It made me like do a double take. I'm not muted. Stop it. Favman16, hey Matt, I'm deeply sorry if my actions earlier in chat when around 11:03 p.m. Central Standard Time I said you fell off. I would love to put aside our differences and get 2 4-for-4 meals from Wendy's. Okay, I'm not, you know, listen, Favman, everyone makes mistakes. I understand. It happens. And you know what? Maybe I have fallen off. You know, I can live with that. No, I'm not wearing blue contacts. It's probably because the red backdrop just really makes these little blueberries pop. My eyes are not actually this blue. This looks like when I like they look. So when I was like in like eighth grade, I would like Photoshop my eyes on Facebook to look like ridiculously blue. And I was like, yeah, people are gonna think that's real. And I'm doing it now. Yeah, let's see. Chat Check your Texas talk, Matt. What's a Texas talk? I don't know what a French talk is. Would I rather smoke with Eminem or Drake? Ah, fuck, man. That's... You guys are asking the fucking... the tough questions tonight. Ah, my eyes. I don't know if it's like what it... I don't know if it's because of what I did today for this video or what, but my eyes are really like burning. You know when you shut your eyes and it's just like... Matt just did an alt-right dog whistle. What did I do? No, I did no alt-right dog whistle. Taco Bell seems to be the move. There's a restaurant in Koreatown called Stoned Plus Hungry. That looks delicious. It's like a waffle with jam and peanut butter on it. What the fuck? Wow, dude, this is the most LA thing. Look at like they like abbreviate each one of the like menu items. So it's like, you can't really see that, but it's like breakfast burger. They take the vowels out of everything. PB&J waffles? Whew, shit. Noscomium said, just sent you a text. No, you didn't. Because you don't even have my number. Would I rather... I'd rather kiss Drake. Drake looks like he'd be a good kisser. Oh, shit, I'm on 1%. Fuck. Hold on, guys. I can't on my phone dying. My head hurts. Been a rough, nauseous day. In the video we shot, I got to see Ryan and Tucker get very violently. I don't understand Taco Bell. It's all made from the same ingredients, which are cheaper and faster to make than going there. Toxic masculinity. I don't know about that one. You know? That one is that's kind of just a just bad. Bad taste.
This dude over here praising God, man.
Sorry, I thought I heard someone talking in my game. Okay. Yeah, I did hear the alcoholic Baja Blast is coming out. That's dangerous. No, I don't have blue light glasses. I should get some. I'll be honest, it's a very hot take, but thanks for actually pronouncing the name. I like that name. My wig's not on backwards. I don't wear a wig. I might have a widow's peak, but I don't wear a wig. Matt, this is the best emote anyone's ever had. Congratulations. That's from Jav Tropic. He's in the chat right now. Okay, I'm ordering Taco Bell.
We calculated how long it took for the Taco Bell to arrive, and we located where Matt Watson lives.
What should I get? Man, that beefy melt burrito. Ooh, yeah. What do I think about getting my balls sucked? Yeah, I don't think so. Beefy melt burrito. Let's see what we got on the menu. God, I'm just getting hot flashes right now. It's the fucking crack addiction. See, my go-to with Taco Bell is a Crunchwrap Supreme. Nachos Bel Grande. We should watch some real life Peter Griffin. Let me order first. Also, if you're ever hosting a party, the move is to go on Uber Eats or just go to Taco Bell and pick up the 12 pack of tacos. If you show up with two of those to a party, you will be the star of that party. I promise you. Every time I have a party at my house, I order like three or four of those like 12 packs with like the Doritos tacos, the soft tacos, the hard tacos. Just put them on the table and I make an announcement. I'm like, come and get them. And then, you know, then everyone goes, whoa, Flamin' Hot Cool Ranch Doritos. Look. Wait a second. I literally was just thinking about. I was just thinking about how I need them to bring back the Cool Ranch Doritos Loco Taco, but now they have the Flamin' Hot trademark Cool Ranch trademark, Doritos trademark, Locos Taco Supreme trademark. So I gotta try one of those. Yeah, I'll try that. Sure. Maybe I should just order a 12-pack and see how many I can eat on stream. That's content, right? For every taco I don't finish, I have to suck myself off. My cat just threw up on my bed, so thanks for that, Matt. It's not my fault. I didn't do that. Sorry. Can't believe I went to fucking space today. Now I'm sitting here ordering Taco Bell in front of 1,000 people. It was fun. It was really fun. We were the first YouTubers in space. And Ryan and Tucker got real sick. But you'll see that in the video. I don't want to spoil too much. Got some soft taco supremes. Ooh, cinnamon twists. You know, like, people give cinnamon twist shit. It was just like pork rinds with cinnamon. They're good. They're really good. What do you think Ryan's superpower would be? Ryan already has superpowers. I don't know if I'm legally allowed to disclose them. I'm going to get a Crunchwrap Supreme. And you know what's really good on the Crunchwrap Supreme is... have you ever heard of Randy Stare? He was a YouTuber gone killer. He kind of looks like you. Is that the guy that had the Danny Phantom... like OCs that he was obsessed with that he thought were like real in another dimension, and he had to like do a mass shooting and then kill himself to go be with them? Okay. yeah. Well, wow, thank you for comparing me to him. I'm very honored. Why would that ridiculous? You know what's really good though is Crunchwrap Supreme extra seasoned beef. Okay. Extra lettuce, extra nacho cheese, extra reduced fat sour cream, extra tomatoes, and avocado ranch sauce? Maybe. No. But cinnamon twists are fucking delicious. Get a K-Dog, broski. What's a K-Dog? I've never heard of Star Chaser, The Legend of Orin. It's on YouTube. It has a criminal lack of views. No, I have not. Sour cream is gross. Okay. Well, I'm a white boy, so I love it. Avocado ranch is pretty good. I'm just gonna get a couple soft tacos. The color of this Flamin' Hot Cool Ranch Doritos taco is not, like, doing it for me. The way it's shown on Uber Eats, but... I'll try. Get some soft taco supremes. Two of those. Hey, Matt, fat bong rip for the boys. Maybe later. I don't want to. Oh, potato K-Dog. Yeah. I've had those. It's actually funny, fun fact about the Korean potato corn dogs is the first time I ever had one was in Harajuku in Tokyo. And I was having a great day. And I would like, I got it. And then I immediately checked my phone. And it was like the announcement of like the mass shooting in New Zealand and just ruined my day. So the first time I ever ate one of those was right when I found out that the Christchurch shooting happened. So now literally for the rest of my life I associate those Korean corn dogs with that shooting, which sucks because now it's like I don't know why my brain had to like permanently associate that. But it's one of those things where it's like I can't undo it. Ooh, should I get Baja Blast? Baja Blast zero sugar? I need a large Baja Blast. God damn it, I hope This is, I'm supposed to be, like, getting really healthy right now. You know what? I'll tell you something. It's my cheat day, which has been every day for the last 2 weeks. But I want some Taco Bell. Life is short. I'm going to eat some Taco Bell. I should be on my diet right now. I should be exercising harder. And what sucks is that I realized this. But, yeah, it'll be here in 10 to 20 minutes. All right. Matt, I'm reading the book. Yeah, I see everyone's getting their hardcovers now. Sorry that it took so long. Fucking supply chain crisis fucked up the production. And then also we had some dumbasses that, so like over in the UK, so I think the books were printed in Poland and then driven on trucks to the UK. And for some reason, like one of the trucks of it, like the guys secured it by like, they tightened the straps so hard that it like crushed three boxes and it ruined like 300 copies of the book. So that fucking sucked because, you know, we don't get the money back for that. Oh, my eyes fucking burn, dude. Look into creatine so you don't lose muscle, Matt. Yeah, no, I take creatine every day. Which I know people have varied opinions on. Matt, have you ever ordered a San Antonio breakfast salad? See, I can't tell it right there if you're actually like genuinely asking me if I've tried some food item or if this is some kind of sexual thing. Oh, Johnny Fantastico said, Matt, you haven't said anything about being New York Times bestseller. So here, okay. Creatine, does creatine make you lose your hair? Don't gaslight me on that one. I'll show tattoos in a second. So Ryan and I sold enough books to classify as New York Times bestsellers, all right? Like we have done that. We hit the numbers. You guys hit the numbers for us for ordering the book. Cause they count like, you know, like audiobook, ebook, all that stuff. The New York Times won't count it because it wasn't in a physical store. So they're like, nah. They can just choose what books are on there. Like, you can sell like a million copies and they can just choose not to have it. So our book's not getting on the New York Times bestselling list, unfortunately. But in my heart, we're New York Times bestsellers because we hit the qualifications. They didn't put us on, but the failing New York Times. The failing New York Times wouldn't put Super Mega Saves the Troops on their top reading list. Yeah, that's Biden's America right here. They won't fucking put our book on the New York Times bestselling list. Hello, it's Milo. So my mailman left my book in the snow and the package got so soggy, but somehow the book survived. I've never been so pissed and so happy at the same time. Damn. Yeah, I saw a lot of mailmen, a lot of people, like, their books got left out in the rain and shit. And, you know, we get a lot of emails saying, like, hey, like, my book's damaged, which sucks for you, so sorry. No, I'm just kidding. We'll replace it for free if you just email support@vidglo.com with your order number and, like, proof that your order's fucked up. And then it's going to take a bit. We're restocking the books right now, but it's going to be, like, 5 to 8 weeks, unfortunately. Probably 4 to 7 at this point. But it's just everything's so slow because of the supply chain crisis. So it will be recorrupted. Sorry, I read Jimbo in chat said Big Book is corrupt and ruining the country. It will be restocked. I know it sounds like a while away, but 5 to 8 weeks, it'll go by like that. And then everyone that got a ruined book from the weather or something can get another free copy. Yeah, exactly. Even after we save the troops, we get no respect. No respect at all. No respect. No respect at all. Yeah, New York Times smokes mid for sure. So, Bean Bean said, what about that one bookshop owner that bought some and sold them in his shop? So, I don't know if I remember someone doing that. However, that doesn't count. They want like big like book chains, like, because we self-funded and self-published and like we had our buddy help us in the UK and we like produced the book fully from the ground up ourselves and got it manufactured and made and published without the help of a publisher, which kind of shot us in the foot because you know, if you go through a publisher, you know, we can get in Barnes & Noble like that. But I'm happy that we self-published. I like doing that kind of stuff more. I think it's a lot more fun. And with a creative project like that, it's really fulfilling. But maybe for the second book, we might have to go through a publisher just so we can get it in Barnes & Noble. Well, we can still get it in Barnes & Noble by self-publishing. It's just a lot harder. And also, publishers will take, like, 30, 40% for, not nothing, but... I don't know. Who would publish a book like that? Scholastic? No. You guys, do you guys really... I hope you enjoy it. Ryan and I are personally happy with it. We had a lot of fun writing it. We were just, like, cracking up the whole time because it's just so funny and we're such good writers. So, good morning from China, Matt. You're not in China? No way. Magoo097? Can you watch Twitch from China? I hope you guys enjoy... also, Gino Samuel's audiobook is... Honestly, the best way to do it is... The best way is to read the physical copy while you listen to the Gino Samuel audiobook, because you get the full experience. You get all the illustrations. You feel smarter because you're actually reading. So gotta go through Penguin to get that shit published. I remember Penguin. He's lying, he's not from China. I knew it! Don't ask Matt what he was doing on April 15th, 1989. I'm going to take a wild guess and say that was the Oklahoma City bombing. April 15th, 1989. It was the Hillsborough disaster, which was a fatal human crush during a football match at Hillsborough Stadium in Sheffield, South Yorkshire, England. What the... You British people have so many stupid fucking... South Yorkshire! What the fuck is that, dude? Stupid Hasbro disaster. Yeah, all the drunk drawings are being turned into NFTs. You're welcome. Oh, hold on a second. Akari Sun subbed. $5 tip. Mahoku Varick said, can I invite you over for some breakfast? I can make homemade biscuits and gravy with some eggs and links if you'd like. I make my own tea too if you want to try some. That actually sounds delightful, and I would love to come over for breakfast. No, okay, also the Tiananmen Square. Okay. Wait, did those both happen on the same day? Wait. Did the Hillsborough Stadium disaster... Oh wow, Tiananmen Square started on the same day as that. The more you know. I would love to come over for breakfast, Moku Varix. Washua Joshua, thanks for the sub. Estes Soup, thanks for the sub. Goop Hug, thanks for the 420. Hey Matt, as dumb as it sounds, when I found out that you also had a phobia of vomit, it honestly meant a lot to me. I'm really glad to hear that you've somewhat overcome it, because I wish I could say the same. Honestly, the best way to overcome it is just in your early 20s, drink too much, so you have to get used to puking. I'm just kidding. I don't recommend that. It sucks. I can't believe anything you guys say. No. Okay. First of all, Cole Maki. Matt, did you hear about the DN disaster? You're going to have to try a little bit harder than that. Okay. Cake Mittens, thanks for the bits. I am an Aquarius, yes. I actually just found out that my zodiac sign is in 1995 and not 1996, because, like, I was born early February 1996, and apparently that counts as, like, the 1995 zodiac calendar. So the more you know. Don't ask Matt about the summer of 69. It was the summer of 69! I don't have something in my teeth. Stop it! Hey, Zygarde 1090, thanks for gifting those subs. And Matt Purple Hat, thanks for the bits. I have the book, I really love it. I tried the audiobook, my brain associates him too much with the Chris Chan documentary, and I just can't do that. I'm weak. Yeah, no, I understand that. If you know, if it's so just associated with the Christian documentary, I get it. But I think that makes it better, in my opinion. How deplorable is the next video? It's not like it's gross or deplorable. It's just really it's wild. It's really wild, I will say. It's like probably the craziest thing we've ever done. And I will say today I got to experience the coolest thing I ever have experienced and probably ever will experience. I got to see the birth of my son. Show your birth chart on stream. I've never done my birth chart. I don't believe in that stuff. Because I think that that's for losers. But no, we did not skydive. A lot of people think that what I'm talking about is skydiving. We did not skydive. That's too boring. We did something cooler than skydiving, honestly. It'll be out soon. I was watching the footage back and I was just like in amazement. I wish I could do it again. Son is trending. What did he say this time? Selma Cash Money has joined the game. See, I'm just enjoying my little house over here. I'm gonna take a sleep. My Taco Bell is on the way as of 3 minutes ago. I'm gonna go get a water from downstairs. I'm a little bit thirsty. Your guys' humor is so dry, you'd get banned by Twitch just for making a joke. That just means that Twitch doesn't understand good comedy, okay? I saw Justin win a bar fight yesterday against the Hell's Angels. Okay, he's him and the Hell's Angels, I don't know what the fuck he did, but they have... Sorry guys, I got, there's a dude here, there's a trader, I believe. Hold on, wandering trader. I don't have any emeralds, fuck, and I do love glowstone, but I can get that. He doesn't have any good shit, so stop with the, okay, I'm gonna go get some water. But someone said that this looked like, oh, can I repeat the Hell's Angels? I've said, Justin's been, I don't know what he did. He's been getting in some shit with the Hell's Angels lately. He's been kicking some ass, honestly. I've seen some of the videos. It's the mic you use for making music. Yeah, I make all my music with this mic and I never have this problem. It's only with, Streamlabs. Heaven's Gate. Sorry, someone said my backdrop looks like the Heaven's Gate. Yeah, it kind of does. Actually, I got another. I should get like a... The new Super Mega Cast set kind of looks like that. Okay, this guy is really annoying. So I hope you guys enjoy listening to him while I go get some water.
Storming through the party like my name was El Nino.
Well, I'm hanging out, drinking in the back of an El Camino as a kid. And a skid, no one knew me by name. Just wanted to have a house party because nobody came. I know I'm not the one you thought you knew back in high school. Never going, never showing, no one behind.
Huh?
become another victim.
Sum 41 is so good. Chat favorite Gatorade flavor? Red's pretty good. It used to be my least favorite. Oh, my order is almost at the door. I'm gonna go explore more. Anything I don't need. Shut up, bro. What the? What are you? Are there two of them? Or are those the alpacas? Okay, I need to make a sword for sure. I don't wanna waste my time, become another casualty of society. I'll never fall in line, become another victim of your conformity. I'll back down. Well, Psalm 41 for you. Little helmet never hurt anybody. Oh shit, what's going on? I'm being raided by who? Who's raiding me? I just spit all. Did you guys see that? Did you see that spit? See that? Oh, that was pretty cool. What we watching when I eat? Well, I think we're gonna watch the Nutty Putty Cave video. Prayer time comes before I eat. I look like I would enjoy a little good Charlotte. What the hell's going on? What's happening? What the fuck? Who's the... Ah! What the fuck? Who is that? What is this? Oh, is this a fucking pillager? Oh, shit. Jordan Peterson, thanks for the raid. I gotta go protect this dude, okay? You little shit. Little bitch. That's right. Got him. You're welcome. Got his ass. Are you guys proud of me for that one? I didn't hide. I actually went and... Oh, and I got this thing. Yeah, dude. Can I have something now? Uh-huh. And I'm gonna put this up over my bed. There's a bug in here. Nice. That really scared me. I did like A Day to Remember, and I did like Good Charlotte. I was very into that stuff. Actually, I got into Good Charlotte because my mom was really into Good Charlotte. And my mom would always, she taught at the elementary school I went to. So she would drive me to school every morning and would play Good Charlotte album. I forgot what it's called. But it has that song. It's like, these are the chronicles of life and death. Can I make some boots? No, I don't enough. I don't think I can make anything else right now. I'm just gonna go put my iron back so I have a little bit saved. Oh, my food's here! Alright, y'all. Well, that's a good place to stop Minecraft for now. See that? So, I'm gonna go ahead and just, stop this here. And when I'm back, we're gonna say our prayers, and we're gonna watch some YouTube videos. 33 Cats, thanks for the sub. Tornelius, thank you for the sub. And the Holy Gold, thank you for the sub. Boom. All right, I'll be right back, guys.
These are the chronicles of... stories of my life that's fictional, that's famous theme.
Oh, sorry, guys. Ruth Conda was me and Ryan's server. Man, the lights are really going crazy tonight. All right. So, that food came really fast. Can you send in videos for me to, for you to watch? I'm trying to figure out the best way to do that. Yeah. I was going to say like a Discord, like in the Super Mega Discord, but that's for patrons. Patrons only. I'm going to use Microsoft Edge. Is Microsoft Edge good? I'm just going to use it because I just wasn't planning on doing this, so I don't know what's going to pop up in my, like, recently searched and shit. What the fuck is going on? Get out of here. What the fuck? Why is it making me enter my fucking PIN for using Microsoft Edge? No, I'm going to end up using Chrome, but I just don't want to use it at the moment just because I just don't know what's going to pop up in my, like, recently searched shit. Not that there's anything bad. I just don't want to embarrass myself, you know? Let's go ahead and Opera is pretty cool. It uses Chromium. It will have all the data Chrome has. Incognito doesn't. You little goofballs. Come in this world and you go out just the same. Nice. There it is. Capture cursor. Let me actually make this the right size.
Man, look at this dude over here praising God, man.
Oh, thank you, Gabby Sheep, for the $5. Have I watched Zach Cable's new show, Smiling Friend? I have not seen, a lot of it, but I mean, I've seen a fair share of it, and I got it. It's awesome. I'm very, very proud of those fellas. Zach and Michael are really cool dudes. Okay, now we're gonna eat. We're gonna dine. I'll stop this music. I got the old Baja Blast for you non-Americans. You see this, this is a large. Look up big boobs. Nope, not doing that. Sorry, bud. I got my Taco Bell. I got it. I know I'm using Microsoft Edge. It's oh my God, they gave me a lot of sauce. Jesus Christ, can you guys like just see the inside of my bag? Triple checking that my address is not on this receipt that I so willingly just showed to the camera. Yep, we're good. Look at how they packed this. It's fucking. I don't remember getting 3 orders of cinnamon twists. The fuck? Well, you know what I did? I fucking. What? I don't know why I have. No, I actually don't know why. Let's see. Filters. Upload date.
this week. How to become an alpha male, right steps.
Tired of fighting with Google to hire top software engineers? Why spend months of time and money competing with big tech companies when you can find the same high-quality talent at the push of a button?
আসসালামু আলাইকুম আশা করছি সবাই ভালো আছেন সব বন্ধুরা চলে আসলাম আরো একটা নতুন ভিডিও নিয়ে সব বন্ধুরা আজকে ভিডিওটা কিন্তু একটু ভিন্ন ধরনের হতে চলেছে কারণ আজকে ভিডিওটা খুবই ইম্পর্টেন্ট সব ভিডিওর মূল টপিক কি ভিডিওর মূল টপিক আজকে আপনাদের সাথে শেয়ার করব ইমো ভয়েস ক্লাবে মাইক যদি লক করা থাকে তারপরও কিন্তু আপনি নিজে আনলক করে সেই মাইকটিতে প্রবেশ করতে পারবেন অর্থাৎ আনলক করার প্রয়োজন হবে না আপনি জাস্ট গ্রুপটিতে যাবেন এবং সেই লকটিতে টাচ করবেন সাথে সাথে আপনি সেই লক ওলা
I already know what he's saying. Real quick, I wanted to pause this for the Flamin' Hot Cool Ranch. They brought back the Cool Ranch Doritos taco. This fucking bug, dude. Get. As you can see, the color is very colorful. I don't know how spicy it's gonna be. I've never actually had this flavor. It's brand new. They brought it back, but they added a little kick. So let's pray real quick, if you guys would mind bowing your heads with me. Lord Jesus, thank you so much for bringing us all here together today. I want to thank you for Prototype Jack, thank you. Lord, I want to thank you for bringing us all here safely today to this stream to all hang out together, and I want to thank you for this food, and I ask you to bless it to nourish our bodies, and I ask that as the coming days proceed, you watch over us and you bless us with your spirit and your presence. In your holy name, we pray. Amen. All right, let's try this taco real quick. A little review bra right here.
Oh, I spilled it. Fuck.
Okay. First thoughts, it's got a bit of a kick, not too much. Not too much of a kick, but it's definitely got something. Going for bite number two. Not that spicy. It's got a nice little kick. It's actually pretty good. I'm not gonna lie. Let's watch some videos by.
I'm Lil Dicky.
Here I just found this. How I destroyed my loser mentality and found my inner alpha by How to Beast. All the pain you have felt and endured was not pointless. This is how I harnessed all that to change my life. Okay, ads. I gotta install ad block for this. That's pretty good. Is that North Korea? That legit? This just looks like Pyongyang. Is this? It's San Francisco. No? Doesn't North Korea have that big triangle? No, that's San Francisco. Okay. Damn, sheesh. Oh shit, dude! It's got the fucking fade! Wait, you guys see that fade? Wait. Right there. You guys see that shit? That's fucking cool. Was that really North Korea? I'm pretty sure that was San Francisco, but... Okay. This is so sick. Ryan and I have been working on a series like this. Is the audio okay? I like
It's the Texas snow apocalypse. I'm on my Dennis Rodman shit. You're probably eating sausages. And your girl is not my hostage, bitch. She chose to be here. You probably chose to be scared, but the hose is prepared.
Oh!
And the bros is prepared.
Oh!
So be aware and beware.
Oh, shit!
Welcome to the video. I hope y'all enjoyed another.
That was smooth as fuck. That was fucking smooth as fuck.
A little bit enjoyable freestyle rap from your boy. And by the way, it's true. Like, the Texas snowpocalypse is back.
Okay, I guess it's like, Texas.
Take a look at this, bro. There's literally... Almost slipped. But there's literally...
I gotta collab with this
icy
guy.
Icy vegetation. There's half inch of snow on the ground. And it's funny being from Boston. Because in Boston, it's
snowing
every
weekend. This
it's
makes a lot of sense.
The whole winter. And you just...
This makes a lot of sense. Okay, I'm gonna... apparently, ads are playing for some people, so I'm gonna pause it. Oh, he got a bad little bitch with him. All right, let's skip through this. Let's see if we actually get some real alpha mentality stuff. Let's see. I don't know. Is that good form? See the way he's like lifting his like lower back up. Is that bad? Like. Isn't that, like, really straining your, like, lower back muscles? And you shouldn't be using those for this exercise, see? It's really, like, jerky. You see that?
10 reps. Felt pretty clean, honestly. Butt came up a little bit on the last rep. A couple more weeks of normal calories.
It wasn't just
carbs.
The last rep, bro.
Maybe we'll get back to 12.
This is badass, man.
Factor tastes good. It saves me time. It gives me more. And then my friends would find out, and everyone would think I was a loser. So I made sure to marketing.
What's he talking about?
It was around like 8 to 10K investment, and I almost didn't even start Edge because of that, because I was afraid I was gonna spend that money, have all these clothes in my apartment, not be able to sell them, and just lose all that money. But because I spent my money, I did every last thing in my fucking control to make
Language.
To sell that clothing. I had sleepless nights for months trying to plan out, you know, the marketing, the design of the clothes itself, everything. I didn't want to lose that.
And y'all know when I was growing up, you know, obviously a big part of my content is that I had zero confidence with girls, and that's because I was afraid that if I told a girl I liked her or that I asked her out and she said no, that it would be painful. It would be embarrassing. Then
they're saying no because you're filming yourself for your YouTube video going up to them. Like, I don't think any girl is comfortable with that.
My friends would find out, and everyone would think I was a loser. So
your friends
are
gonna think you're a loser for doing what you're doing.
By never asking a fucking girl out and never approaching girls. And
truth.
That is why being a loser growing up is actually a sneaky superpower. Because check it
truth.
Out. Even though I was avoiding the pain of those small rejections every chance I could, eventually I had this realization. And this is when I turned into an approach machine. And I started approaching every last girl I had even a little bit of interest in. I started realizing, holy fuck, if I see a girl... who I want to talk to and I don't talk to her, that's actually causing me more pain because that girl,
true.
I could have a date with her tomorrow night. I could hook up with her the next night.
Yep.
That could be my next girlfriend. And if I don't even talk to her, I'm never going to know and I'm losing out on all of these potential opportunities. And that became so painful that I would do anything to avoid that
this
pain.
This dude's just harassing women.
Here. Whenever you can spend...
Even the ugliest bitch that, you know, might give a little good head, I'd go up and ask her. You know, because, you know, if she says no, at least, like, I approached, and now I know. I'm glad that there's a part about girls in this.
Money to help yourself get closer to a goal. They see making improvements to the website. Like, we just added the color selector in, so you can quickly swap between different...
So, for dinner, we're running late. And I'm not going to say it was an instant classic.
Wait.
All right. Movie review. Julia.
8 out of 10. It was good.
7.5. I liked it.
I had low expectations.
What movie you guys think they saw?
And I'm not gonna say it was an instant classic.
Jackass?
But I'd give it a 7.8 out of 10. I thoroughly enjoyed it.
7.8?
A lot of movies like don't explain.
Got Anthony Fantano out here.
Don't explain like what actually went down. This movie like went out of its way to try and explain the theory behind the movie. You know what I'm saying?
Had the Game of Thrones guy in there too, so.
Yes, Sam.
Dude, I'm like teeth chatteringly cold, man. I didn't know Texas was like this, I'm out.
What are the comments like on these? David is back. I actually pay $9.99 at Edge and pull all the bix. Your rap parts are always so cringe, bro. Haha, love the videos though. See, this is the way you do it. This is what I do it. Now I go down, I just start clicking other channels from the comments, and this is how we go down a rabbit hole.
Marketing for affiliates, and they do all the selling. Literally, my boys run the back end of things. We really don't have to do a lot, and it does incredibly.
I know something about the boys running the back end. All right, so that's a dead end. So let's see what else we can.
Marketing.
Hold on. Search beta male and just go by newest. I love this picture. It's one of my favorite pictures. Man, I love being the fucking, I don't know if it's still, but when you search beta male smile, I come up for like just a lot of the pictures. Upload date. Beta male rehab tip. Have endless abundance. Let's see.
You must understand that seeing things from a female perspective and not a man's is so freaking key. You must understand that seeing things from a female perspective and not a man's
fucking feminist king
is so freaking key. You must.
That is freaking key, man. What about beta female versus sigma male? Oh, dude, I love these videos. Like the Indian dude with like the ice cream cone and like just tricking him. Like, oh, you want the ice cream? Oh, just kidding. Oh, I love it.
Ruko jara, sabar kar.
I was pretty badass, honestly. Is it okay to be single? Beta male rehab? One trick's point never, still life, extended beta male version. What's the beta male version? I'm giving this guy props. IRL cringe beta male does push-ups every night until he's a Chad, day 9.
Hi, it's David here. It's couch time. I worked 13 hours today delivering.
He's got some Tobuscus sideburns going on. Damn. I need to see the push-ups. Okay. Little stretching, that's always good. It's always good to stretch before you work out. Let's see, alright, ready?
You see me suffer now. You see my facial.
What, did he do them yet?
It's not pleasant.
Oh no, he hasn't started yet. Oh, let's go! Head forward, back straight. Okay. Hey, you know, I admire this. Stop saying this is me in 20 years. This man is not a beta either. He's already achieved the sigma mindset. Would I get in trouble if I listen to Penis Extension Binaural Beats? Are those a copyright claim? You know how big penis is. God damn. I just remembered a really funny video, dude. I found this video a while back with Jackson of this, like, plumber that just fucks up these... He's doing some, like, rudimentary, like, like, plumbing shit, and he just, like, fucks it up so bad, and the video is just him just trying to fix it.
And it's like, I feel really bad for the guy because it's obviously like a huge bust, but like, it just goes on for so long. Let me see if I can find it. Hold on. Plumber causes flood. I love this video so much. So it's like, not, it, you know, at first it's like, ah, oh, man.
And it's like super hot too.
Yeah, I feel bad for him because it's really fucking hot. Like, you can see the steam. Like, that sucks. Oh, this poor fucking guy. Like, my man is in the rapids. You're right. So it's like, oh, he's got it. He's got it. The problem solved. You know, a little bit of water damage, you know? Yeah, like, turn off the water. I don't understand. All right. Oh, Critical talked about this? So basically, it doesn't stop. And you go like 10 minutes in. Well, there's an ad for Inglewood DNA.
Welcome to the wood.
Hold on, guys. Now I see how you feel. I don't know why they're bringing race into this. I'm reading this description. The landlord, a very problematic, very cheap Persian female, calls in self-appointed Hispanic plumber named Wilmer. Wilmer is the kind of cheap labor that cuts corners to try... Where did this, like, racial thing come from all of a sudden? For all the morons who complained that I should have put down the camera and helped this waterlogged jackass, I chose not to help for liability's sake and instead documented the incident. No, bro, you're just fucking lazy. This man is out here fucking boiling water spraying in his face. Is it fixed? God. This poor fucking dude. I feel so bad for him. Yeah, I don't understand the fucking like racial aspect of the description. It's like, nah, if he helped, he could have been held liable. Oh, okay. I guess. I can just tell the guy's an asshole, though, by the way you typed that. Nutty Putty Cave. I promise you guys this. Critical made a video on this. Basically, they couldn't shut off the water because it was an apartment complex or something. It would cost a lot of money to turn it back on for the city. Okay. That's such bullshit because I've had something similar where... because I live in LA, there's like, the gas lines have like an emergency, like earthquake switch. So if it senses an earthquake, it shuts off the gas, automatically. So there's not like, you know, a gas explosion if a big earthquake happened. You have to pay to get it turned back on. So if like a little earthquake happens and your gas gets shut off, you have to legit call them and fucking pay to get your gas turned back on. It's like the stupidest shit. So every time a little earthquake happens, they probably make a ton of money. Yeah, this is fucking... So this is one of my favorite channels. Fascinating Horror. I highly suggest subscribing. This guy makes the best videos. So let's watch this one. Also, let me know like if the volume is too loud or anything. I'll go ahead and make it...
At around 8 p.m. on the 24th of November 2009,
is it too loud?
John Edward Jones, an avid amateur caver,
yeah, we can watch the whole thing.
Entered the Nutty Putty Caves just south of Salt Lake City in Utah. He was accompanied by a large...
He's Mormon. I'm calling it now. He's Mormon. You look at that family from Salt Lake City. That is a Mormon man right there. These are Mormon men. Mucho Lucho, should I take a shot? Yeah, go for it. The Krabby Patty Caves? okay. Yeah, so if you guys don't know about this case, this is really freaky. But let's get on with it.
Large group of family and friends. It was, after all, just before Thanksgiving. The trip was intended to be a brief adventure that they could share before the holiday. What it turned into was a living nightmare that would cost John Edward Jones his life.
This is one of my biggest, this is one of the scariest things I've found.
The Nutty Putty Caves were first discovered in 1960 and were named for the soft brown clay which lined many of the passages.
Yeah, someone last time I brought this up was like, imagine losing your life in a place called Nutty Putty Caves, which is an L in itself, but also it's like, this shit's scary. This shit is the Nutter Butter Cave. Yeah, it's unfortunate that they named the cave such like a goofy name because of deep water diving. Okay, we'll watch some of that next. A delivery boy though says, I know something about soft brown clay lining passages, my man. Okay, so you can see we've got the map here. We've got the crack. That's where it looks like that's where you come in, maybe the big room. And we'll see. We'll see what happens. I'm sure nothing goes wrong in Nutty Putty Caves.
Connected by narrow, low-ceilinged corridors. Although it required a great deal of wriggling and crawling to navigate, it was considered a good cave system for beginners and was visited by thousands each year.
I could never do this.
Those visitors could enjoy features which included the big slide.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
A room wherein the floor descended at a 45-degree angle.
This does not sound fun at all. This is fucking terrifying.
A confusing jumble of tiny chambers and tight corridors that were fun to explore.
No, that's not fun to explore. That's terrifying. You're underground and you're in a fucking pitch black maze of rock with tight corridors and tiny chambers. That's like the worst
fucking...
And
contained a hollow rock that was said to ring like a bell when struck.
That's kind of cool.
As supposedly beginner-friendly as the caves were, they weren't without issue. From 1999 to 2004, a number of people, including two Boy Scouts, became stuck in tight or narrow parts of the caves and had to be rescued by professionals.
Sucks for them.
These incidents led to some changes.
Who's letting little Boy Scouts go down in the Nutty Putty Caves?
After being gated for a number of years, the caves were reopened with a registration system in place. Groups would have to book online to ensure that cave management knew who was down there, and the caves wouldn't be overly crowded at any one point in time. That was the situation when John Edward Jones and his friends and family.
I swear this guy is like a guy that I've known my whole life. Like his face, this looks like someone that I know. I can't put my finger on it, but like, doesn't he just look like he just looks like the type of guy that like you, everyone knows this guy. Like everyone has this guy in his life somewhere. Like he kind of looks like a deep fake, like AI, created face. But anyway, John Edward Jones is entering the Nutty Putty Caves on the 24th of November.
Entered the Nutty Putty Caves on the 24th of November, 2009. Amongst the group was John's brother, Josh.
He looks
Between them, the two siblings had a great deal of caving experience. During their childhood, they had gone on numerous underground adventures across the state of Utah, although they had never before visited the Nutty Putty Caves.
I hate that.
For almost an hour, the trip went well.
I hate the way that looks.
The group crawled, scrambled, and inched their way through the caverns, delighted by each new discovery. At around 9 p.m., John found what he thought was the entrance to Birth Canal, a well-known stretch of the caves, so named because of how tight and narrow it was. The passageway which confronted John certainly fitted that description.
The birth canal, boys.
He squeezed inside and wriggled forward. When the narrow crevice took a downward turn, he hesitated for only a moment. The narrow space looked as though it might open out a little bit further down, and besides, he was sure that he was in Birth Canal, a passage which he knew could be safely navigated if he just kept his nerve. Unfortunately, John wasn't in Birth Canal after all. Instead, he was wriggling headfirst down an uncharted tunnel in a different part of the caves.
That, fuck that. That's so, oh my god. Like, I understand the, like, adventurous side of this, but go skydiving or something, dude. Like, climbing down into, like, the deepest crevasses of the earth. Head first. I can't wrap my mind around it.
A tunnel, it's like an anthill, that had never been charted, specifically because it was far too small. Unaware of the danger, John crawled onwards until he couldn't. When he realized he was stuck, he was head down in an almost vertical passage, the diameter of which was smaller than a front-loading washing machine.
Oh, fuck that. Oh, my God.
He couldn't move an inch. John's brother Josh was close behind him and soon realized something was wrong. When he learned that John was stuck, he first attempted to pull him out,
but
was
able
only to shift him a few inches. Realizing that the situation was beyond them, Josh raced back out of the caves to fetch help,
while another friend waited by John's side.
Within hours, rescue teams were on site. They were faced with an intensely difficult operation. It was now midnight, and pitch black outside the caves as well as in.
Nope.
The place where John was...
He's deep in the butthole of this cave, and he's not only stuck in like a super narrow space, he's upside down, and it's pitch black. And it's dark outside too, so it's like, it's black everywhere. Oh my god. This is just fucking... This poor guy, this is...
Stuck was incredibly narrow, meaning that however many resources were available, only one person could get close enough to access him at any one time. John remained as calm as was possible under the circumstances. Indeed, when the first rescue worker arrived on scene, he thanked them for coming and told them that he really, really wanted to get out.
I bet.
Making that happen would prove to be next to impossible. Rescue workers attempted to drill out the rock around John, but were able only to widen one small part of the passage by a few inches.
Oh, this 3D diagram? Oh, fuck that, dude. Look at this cross-section. 10 inches? The widest part is 10 inches. And that's... He's not in the widest part.
Even after hours of labor. Abandoning this idea, they rigged up a system of ropes and pulleys, securing a loop around John's legs, the only part of him that they could reach. They started the slow and painful process of hauling him out. At first, it seemed like this tactic might succeed. They were able to raise him a significant distance out of the vertical crevice in which he was stuck.
Although, thank you, Mucha Lucha 101.
So caused John and a great bomb deal of pain.
And doink salad.
While they stopped to rest, a radio was lowered down to John so that he could communicate with his pregnant wife, who waited for him outside the cave.
This is just making me incredibly sad now. Like, I've known about this story, and like, that was a perfect time for that sound effect. Now I'm just sad. Oh my god. Well, now I don't even want to finish it. You guys want to watch something else, or do you want to keep watching this? I didn't mean to ruin your day, guys. Yeah, okay. Yo, my wife's pregnant. Better call into this narrow-ass crevasse. Yeah, it is a little irresponsible, I think. I mean, I'm not gonna judge the man's actions, the late man's actions. But it's Jesus. You can go finish this this video if you guys want. But that hit me. That made me really, really sad. So let's go. One of my favorite things to look up is Eminem cover, and go and sort by newest, and you find some really good shit. Sometimes. Let's look up this week. All right. Let's see. No views 4 hours ago. I just don't give a damn. Hashtag remix, hashtag cover, hashtag Eminem, hashtag Satanism, hashtag Christianity, hashtag TikTok, hashtag Hail Satan.
Whoa, now get your hands in the air. Cause here we go, fucking again, and again, and again. Now listen, Christians, you are brain dead like your savior Jesus. Now I just wanna fucking say, I don't give a fuck.
Oh shit!
About your fucking imaginary guy in the sky, the magical wizard. I don't wanna fucking be saved by him.
Shit!
So listen for the last time, Christians.
Listen up, Christians.
I just don't give a fuck.
This guy doesn't give a fuck!
Now if you see me on your For You page, don't tell me about your fucking God. Don't tell me he loves me.
Don't tell this guy about your fucking God.
Cause I just don't give a fuck.
Oh shit!
Your fucking God can suck my fucking cock. Whoa. Now get your hands in the air.
Damn. That was insane, man. Yeah, checkmate Christians. When he takes the glasses off, that was... This is the Dark Pope? This dude had a bad church experience as a kid. So he's a Satanist. I don't want to get copyright striked. Yeah, dude. This guy kind of sounds like he has like some possession in. Well, I mean that was great from the to bring the mood back up. This one's pretty good. I just don't give a damn. Hashtag remix. Let's see if we got some more Eminem covers we can find. This looks promising. Dude, I love houses like this. Sorry, man, I gotta go back to the Dark Pope. What do you think Jesus is doing at this moment?
You know what I think about? I wonder, is Jesus now at this moment cheering you on like, yeah, fuck Satan? Or does he cry? I just wonder, any thoughts? Hey, Satan.
Fuck yeah, dude.
You know what I think about?
Is he in like a hospital room? Like, what is this? In the, like, look in the background. Like, it looks like some kind of, like, medical machine or something.
This moment cheering you on, like, yeah, fuck sick.
Yeah, this guy had a bad church experience. He probably got bullied at youth group.
That's correct. As a non-theistic Satanist, I do not believe in Satan as a deity. I believe in what he represents. Ave Satanis, hail Satan.
Ooh, that was a sexy little stare at the end. Hail Satan. Eminem and Indian version.
ऐसा है कि हमने धरती पर उतार ले लिए हैं और भय भूत भ्रष्टाचार बेरोजगारी महंगाई दहेज हत्या बलात्कार डकैती चुनौती चोरी बेमानी डाई यूरिया पोटास करोड़ों सौ लाइन चाइन व्यत्याप्रति नीति धर्म अत्याचार अनाचार दुराचार व्यवचार भ्रष्टाचार कदाचार कैसे कम होगा यह किसी को मालूम नहीं है पहली बात दूसरी बात इन नेताओं को अभी नहीं मालूम है कि बड़े भाग्य मानुष तन पावा सूर दूर लगता जनसन दवाई लोग खाली एमएलए एमपी विधायक सांसद बने थे दूसरी बात इन लोगों को यम नियम आसन प्रत्याहार ध्यान धारणा समाधि अस्त्य ब्रह्मचर्य अध्यात्म अद्भुत वीर उत्साही कर्मण संत स्वामी ऋषि मुनि ज्ञान
How long is this? Yeah, that's actually what Eminem would be like if he was from India. Metal fake monk Eminem cover. My dad's gone crazy, Eminem cover.
Today we're going to talk about father and daughter.
I'm just muting it for a second because of the instrumental. I don't want to get DMCA'd. Come on, get to the rapping, bro.
There's no mountain I can't climb. There's no tower too high. No plane that I can't learn how to fly. What do I gotta do to get through to you to show you there ain't nothing I can't take this chainsaw to? Fucking brains, brawn, and brass balls. I cut them off and got them pickled in bronze in a glass jar inside of a hole.
Someone come get they dad. This is sick. Demon Inside. Eminem and Young M.A. unaccommodating instrumental cover. And why does this say, where is Osama Bin? I just want to see the Godzilla covers. So they, because they start with the best fucking line. I could swallow a bottle of.
Oh, you're a monster. I can swallow a bottle of. And I'll. Feel like Godzilla, better hit that like a Godzilla. My whole squad's in it, walking around on the party. Cross speed, being a zombie, a plox, and a bit of a bomb. The way we use it is dropped in a similar and I'm
wrestling. Alright, this goes off. What could he swallow a bottle of?
Oh, you're a monster. I can swallow a bottle of anal.
A bottle of anal? It sounds a bottle of anal. You hear that?
I can swallow a bottle of anal.
What? Does this song have a really fast part? Yeah, I swear he says a bottle of anal. You guys hear that?
Oh, you're a monster.
I like that. I really like that audio clip.
I can swallow a bottle of anal. Feel like Godzilla. Better hit that like a Godzilla. My whole squad's in it, walking around on the party. Cross speed, being a zombie, a plot.
Is this really Eminem?
The brain is really dropped in a similar and I'm wrestling mania. Shit is time to watch them. I can't sit across and make it scotchy on the screen on bed. Not the insomnia, ADHD, hard shots to go.
I wonder if he does Juice WRLD's part in this song. Oh, dude, does Juice WRLD say the word in this song? Because this guy might say the word if he's covering it. We're looking up Drake covers next.
Locking on the way to bring it up, spit the flings, then I'm gonna play it with that monster. If you get in my way, I'ma feed you to the monster. I'm normal during the day,
but this goes hard as fuck.
Monster. When the moon shines on, I throw truckers, look alike, let out throwing dog busters, gods
in the fire
spirit, a monster. Blood on the dance floor, Louis V carpet, fire full on missile, whistle fire, gods in the fire, blood on the garden pass, and I like what you do when you hand summons flyers, and what goes around comes around like the blades on the chainsaw.
How's that clap? Okay. Clap the right side of the had it for a second.
I've got the most for the season, they call me Diddy. I get that big.
Bobo, 333, thanks for the sub.
I'm too soon of a share.
What did he just say?
I'm too soon of a share. I wouldn't engineer anything to bring it together, but I'll marry her and she'll learn her. How Jack orders and Richard means, but she'll read scores and literature and say what they want to give me a share.
Did he switch languages up on the beat? Beat was so fire, he started speaking in tongues. Alright, that one's pretty good. This guy was some more, David Pace. Does this guy only upload Eminem covers? Oh, he's got 7,000 subs. Oh, shit, look at this. He does some Method Man and Red Man. Oh, yeah. This guy's awesome. Alright, let's look up some Drake covers. I really want a cover of, I always forget the fucking name of the song. I said, you the fucking best, you the fucking best. I went to a karaoke with, at a bar with Brandon Wardell and, Caleb and Patrick from Pot About List. And, we did, Forever by Drake. And we also did, that you the fucking best. The white boys were going crazy that night. Tell you what. So also what I find is if you sort by upload date, you usually go and hit, like, don't hit last hour because you're not going to find anything. You need to hit, like, this week because it'll show you everything from the last week. So if you want to do what I'm doing, do upload date and then this week. Let's see. This dude's beard is crazy. None of these look too enticing. Drake white cover? Best I ever had. Drank thanks me later. Drum overdub cover. Fantasia style improv. Come on, where's the good Drake fucking covers? Drake Bell cover. Okay. This looks like a young Timothy Chalamet. Yeah, nothing coming up too much for that. Rap God fast part. If I do Rap God fast part, sort by upload date, I might get something good. I did the Rap God fast part perfectly 6 hours ago. Oh. Okay. Okay. Oh shit. All right. Okay. Okay. That was damn. All right. That's not what I was expecting with that one. All right. He kind of looks like, he kind of looks like young me, like, in the hair and, like, the neck and... Okay, that was pretty insane. Attempting Eminem Rap God fast part. No, that's a... I don't want to watch a child. This one does look pretty promising. Oh, wait, One Breath. He does this all in one breath. All right, I kind of gotta see this if he does it in one breath.
Oh, I turn up.
I turn up.
I'm gonna try to rap God. It's my first time being on actual camera, but like
see it.
First time in 2022. Let's go.
I bet he's gonna fucking slay it.
All right, here we go.
One breath. Oh, shit! That was fucking awesome. He really did it in one fucking breath, too. That was fucking sick, dude. Why is it just kids doing this? Can we please watch the Mikey Bolts Rap God cover? I don't know what that is. I'll look that up. I don't want the instrumental to fucking get me DMCA'd. This about to be crazy though.
You know, I'm beginning to feel like a rap god. All my people from the front to the back no. Now who thinks they're all
this is sick, man.
Slap box.
They said I rap like a robot,
so call me rap box. For me to rap like a computer must be in my jeans. Got a laptop in my back pocket, my pen will go off when I have cough. Got a fat knock from that rap prophet.
Does he do any other voices besides Stewie?
You wanna rip it, did he wanna...
No, he just does Stewie. Damn.
Damn. Not bad, though. Rap God fast part.
Rain check, my straight to the radio station. A very nice day. Hey, Fab, I'ma kill you. Lover's coming at you, should be sonic speed. Some of the weather with you, assuming I'm human. What I gotta do to get it through, and I'ma still be human in a minute. And I'm a
human. Right.
And so anything you say is ricocheting off of me. Devastating more.
Alright, little man. Ooh, Nightcore Eminem. I can't play that because I'll get DMCA'd. It's just little kids. It's just, why is it only kids that attempt this cover? I did it faster than original Eminem. Alright. Pretty fast.
Lyrics coming at you like supersonic speed, JJ Fab. Super Luna, do my US, I mean, I'm only a human, so I to get through to you to get a superhuman. I'm a maiden robber, so anything you can say, react your shit enough of me, it'll grow to you. Some devastating more of a demonstration, how to get a motherfucker, you know, just feeling like liberating. Haters want to do that, they can say I feel of their celebrating, but I will know to get motivated. I make elevating music, you make elevator.
You want to know how I got these scars? My
All right.
Father was a drinker and a fiend. And one night, he goes off crazier than usual. Mommy grabs the kitchen knife to defend herself. He doesn't like that. Not one bit. So me watching, he takes the knife to her, laughing while he does it. He turns to me and says, "Why so serious?" He comes at me with the knife. "Why so serious?"
Don't! The hairs on my arms are standing up, guys. You see that? Oh, that was fucking... Look at the hairs on my arms, guys. You see that shit standing up? That was sick. I need a mic.
What's that?
What is this?
It's a fucking tool. That's not... It's a fucking rolling pin. What are you, Fanny Credit? What are you gonna do with that, babe?
You wanna know how I get...
The hell was that?
How about alive? Hmm? You wanna know how I got these scars? See, my father was a drinker and a fiend. And one night, he goes off crazier than usual.
That one was pretty good. I love that the shirtless dude, like, playing the movie and looking up at his TV just to make sure he's on cue. Forrest Gump impressions.
It's knife, laughing while he does it. He turns to me, and he says, "Why so serious?"
Oh, shit!
Comes at me with the knife. "Why so serious?" Sticks the blade in my mouth.
Yikes. The best Joker impression video is the kid that's doing it in his dorm room, and then his roommates walk in, and he, like, tries to, like, play it off. I mean, that's a classic cringe video. I'm sure most of you have seen that.
Have you guys seen that one? This one. This is like this, have you guys seen this? It's, he's doing a Joker impression in college and his roommates walk in and he's just trying to like play it off. Like he's, you know, just, this one's good.
Dude, your room is a mess.
I know.
What the hell's wrong with you, man? What are you doing? What
is this? Making a video.
You making a video?
Yeah.
Why you paint your face, bro?
Because I'm being the Joker.
Why are you being the Joker, dude?
Dude, because the Joker's awesome. Get off it.
Dude, but you ain't even close to looking like him, dude. You gotta be white in the face, bro.
Of course not. I didn't want to put the white stuff on and have to wait half an hour for it to dry before I put the
you
black
You like the Joker?
On. Yeah, he's awesome.
Well,
he's
pretty cool. Because
he likes the Joker.
Holy shit, dude.
The Joker's messed up. I saw that movie last night.
Can you laugh like the Joker?
No, I don't. That's scary.
Don't.
You don't hear
it. Don't laugh
dude,
like
dude,
me.
Dude.
I don't remember if he... No, stop! No, stop!
That's pretty good.
Oh, man. That's pretty good.
No, probably not. It's just the thing I have for the Joker. That's it.
I'm gonna go eat this candy cane and play video game.
Alright, fine. Have fun.
Someone said pussy career ended right there. I think pussy career started right there. It was bad, and then it got to the laugh, and he just kept going. Yeah, this is Germa. Classic Joker baby. Yeah, his friends were all right. They're like, oh, you like the Joker? Cool. Oh, whoa, what? I didn't know that this could go up like that. Oh, nice. Oh, shit. Honestly, just rant is a good thing to. Like, go to rant and then sort by, like, honestly, just today.
We've achieved equity. They've won. Meanwhile, in a nod to the burgeoning wellness movement, the orange character will, quote, acknowledge and embrace his anxiety. And actually, if you look at him, the orange fox does appear very anxious.
WWE SmackDown rant for February 11th. A lot of Sonic rants. The political rants are always fun. It's rant time. You don't want to miss this one. I'm gonna lose my mind on this one. Lots of shit pissing me off. Oh, this is 3 hours? What the fuck? No. Okay. So doing this, I do happen to stumble upon quite a bit of what I'm guessing is schizophrenics. Like channels like this, for example.
I can't go to jail for a video I didn't steal.
What?
I gotta get the leather. It's probably the way under there, I guess.
What? That's why, the depths of YouTube, you know, you can get, like, you can get some really beautiful stuff.
No Super Mega Rants? Gonna have to change that. Damn. That's too bad. Alright, going back to this one. What's a good Fedora hat trick tutorials? It's not bad. Gary V. I don't want to watch any Gary V videos. That guy's crazy. Cosplay ASMR videos. That's definitely against TOS. Look up Super Mega Fart. Dude farts on the camera. No, I'm just seeing. Is it this one? That's good. That's good. I'm gonna go ahead and we'll do a Tom Pearl watch along. What time is it? It's almost midnight. I'm gonna get off and go watch some TV or something. So I'll find one good video to end it for us. Let's see. Okay, this video, the best cry ever. That's never made me laugh. That shit's just really fucking sad. Cause it's from an episode of Intervention, I think. And, like, it's about a guy with, like, a drug addiction or something. And his, like, friend or whatever is like, I still love you. And he starts crying. And it became, like, a huge meme. And it's so fucking sad. I've always just been so, like, heartbroken by that video. Can I play Roo Pooty? Or is that against, that's against terms, probably. I was gonna search Pokimane rant, but I'll steer clear of that one. Isn't Tobuscus a big Republican now? Let's not go down this rabbit hole.
Three days only, today through Sunday. Save thousands on hot tubs and swim spas. Trade-ins welcome, free delivery. We'll even haul away your old spa.
Hey, how about that? Hey, how about that, dude? Ooh, that's a classic one right there. Yep. Wait for it. Is that it? That's it. Well, I guess that was a good one to end it on. Bye, guys.